Did I just hear that correctly?
In my head.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to In My Head. Two quick things. The first, I'm from the United States of America. So if you're from a different country or a different culture, the things that I say here, they may not apply the same for you. Number two, I am not a licensed professional. So here on In My Head, I give my take on mental health issues, and something happened at a Tony Robbins seminar that I wanted to talk about. For those that don't know, Tony Robbins is a famous self-help speaker. He's a motivational speaker. He's not your guru, but he goes around the world and holds these seminars that are meant to be very uplifting and motivating and inspiring. Recently, he held a seminar, and this woman had gotten up to speak, as is typical in his seminars, and she wanted to talk about how she felt like he was mischaracterizing the Me Too movement. A video of this had been posted to Facebook, and as people watched and they saw the interactions between the two back and forth, a lot of people were uncomfortable with the way that Tony Robbins was speaking and behaving. Of course, there were also others who agreed with everything that he had to say. I wanted to give my opinion, and I will explain how that ties back into mental health, but I particularly wanted to talk about one point that I'll get to in just a little bit. First, I wanted to give a little bit of background. So I have attended a Tony Robbins seminar myself at a time when I was experiencing symptoms of mental illness and also physical illness. So I apologize to anybody who was in that seminar who I may have gotten sick. Personally, I found that experience to be this weird mixture of being really uplifting and empowering, but also feeling very invalidated. Overall, I walked away from the whole experience feeling amazing. I felt great, but then as time went on and I reflected backwards on the things that had happened, I questioned if it really was that great. I have mixed feelings. What I saw in this video is actually a great example of this feeling that I'm trying to convey. We see that Tony had asked this woman to stand up and speak what was on her mind, and she did. But when she was speaking, he talked over her, and his body language was not really in sync with what he was saying. There was this weird mixture of trying to empower this woman, but also speaking down to her and speaking for her. That's how I perceived it. You can make your own judgment. But as I said, there's one thing in particular that he said that I really wanted to talk about. He mentioned that he was not knocking the Me Too movement, he was knocking victims. Now, I'm sure that he didn't mean that he was actually knocking victims. He meant that he was knocking people who have a victim mentality. And I get that, and I understand the point that he was trying to make. But rather than just leave it so black and white, I want to dig a little bit deeper. I've talked a lot on my channel about trauma and how trauma affects us. Trauma is something that can send people into depression, and it may leave them having a negative attitude. When your life has been threatened, it's not gonna look like the world is a very friendly place. You're probably gonna feel like it's a harsh world, and it's not a place that you enjoy living in. That's normal. In fact, those are symptoms. You don't just think them away or change your mentality. On the other hand, though, yes, it's important to challenge those negative beliefs and to try to fight back whenever possible. But you also do that with the understanding that you don't always have the power or the energy to be able to fight back against those negative thoughts. As I talked about in my video yesterday about depression, if the dopamine isn't there, it's not there. No amount of trying to change your attitude is going to motivate you if your body physically cannot do it. And it doesn't do any good to knock somebody who is a victim who is expressing symptoms of being a victim. Just like it doesn't do any good to knock somebody who has a fever for having a fever. You can do something about what you've experienced, just like when you have a fever, you can go and seek out a solution like medication to try to better your experience. And yet you can also still feel shitty while you're doing that, and you're allowed to express that you feel shitty. And people who have been victimized have a legitimate reason to have a negative attitude. But I know what Tony is trying to say. It's important that we're proactive about our circumstances and we don't get caught in the cycle of negativity. It's important that we look for solutions when and where we can. It's important that we do not lose hope and we keep getting up even when things are hard. I think people like Tony Robbins, who have large audiences, they need to know and they need to understand the experiences of the people who they're talking to. When you've experienced trauma and you come out of it with these symptoms, there's a strong need to be heard about what you've gone through. This could be an expression of the panic/grief system. That's a neurological system in your body that everybody has. It's something that I mentioned in yesterday's video. If we cry out for help and we're not listened to, we can fall into depression. Now I understand, Tony's not a therapist, neither am I. And one person can't validate everybody, nor is it their responsibility to. It's not Tony's fault if he doesn't listen to somebody and they fall into depression, but he is partially responsible if he's talking with them and he talks over them. He, like everyone, has a choice of whether to listen and reflect back what he's heard or to invalidate the person he's speaking with. And all of us should at least be aware that when we invalidate somebody's experience, there's the possibility that we are re-traumatizing them. If the way that we treat them is the same way that they were treated when they were traumatized, it's very likely that they will re-experience the trauma. This could make their symptoms flare up, and it could worsen their condition. If somebody who has been victimized is asking to be acknowledged and we invalidate them, we're partially responsible for that. Now, I don't think that Tony intended to invalidate this woman, but I think that most people watching would agree that that's what he did. He asked her questions, but then he pretty much answered those questions for her. He continually told her what she was thinking or what she should be thinking without ever reflecting back that he heard what she was saying. He could do better. Now, the point that Tony was trying to make about how attacking other people makes them feel defensive and it makes it hard for them to hear your message, yes, that's important, and I always try to bring that message up here on my channel as well. And he has a right to express that point as much as this woman has the right to express her point. Where he dropped the ball here was not listening to what she was expressing. He got defensive himself and he wasn't able to hear her, even though she really wasn't attacking him, which is out of sync with what he was saying. He said that he didn't feel attacked, but then he behaved as though he was. So what I want to know is, did you see the video? What did you make out of all of this? Leave that down below in the comments. Let's have a respectful discussion about this. If you're new here and you like to learn about mental health, go over to youtube.com/RyanLiberty, hit subscribe. Thank you everybody for joining me here on In My Head. If I want to throw stones in my own house, that's what I'll do.